Hi, students. This is, I think, the third lecture. This is more of just kind of clarity. I just was worried that you guys may be confused about SA3. I'm teaching this exact class live at Skyline right now, and the students are having a lot of trouble with SA3. So I thought I would do this just to give you guys some clarity on what you're supposed to do. So if you look on Canvas, I did upload something called SA3 notes. So I'm going to go to that right now and I'm going to kind of talk you guys through it. So because I'm teaching this exact same class at the exact same time in person, we did a lot of work on thesis statements in class today. And I had the students, we basically write them on the whiteboard and then we workshop them. And so I shared them with you guys so you can kind of see some of the thesis statements that the other students are doing. And I just want you to know, like, feel free to use someone else's thesis statement. It's not plagiarism. Writing is a community effort. And even if you use the exact same thesis statement as someone else, it doesn't mean that you're essay will be in any way the same. So please feel free to use any of these thesis statements or alter them. You have permission from me and you have permission from the students who I asked if I could do this. So one thing I do in class is I have them write their thesis statements on the board and then I have them color code, underline, and number each of the points. And what this does is it helps the students see the organization of their essay. So like you always want your points to go in order, right? So like your point one will be paragraph one, point two will be paragraph two, and then so on and so forth. And I really want you in this thesis statement for this essay to make it complex, right? You want to have an opinion, a reason, and then the so what at the end, right? Like what should be done about this? And so I provided a lot of different, I think there's like eight different thesis statements and they've been altered. So, I approved every single one of these. They're all good. Looking at this thesis statement, the one thing that I've noticed for this essay is that people took the forgiveness question a little too literally. Like, you don't want to write about whether or not someone should be forgiven, as far as like, I think someone was arguing that Anthony Ray Hinton should forgive the state for putting him in prison. that's going to be a hard one to argue just because I don't know anyone that would really think that that's correct. But also, it's just forgiveness is such an abstract concept. You want to focus on something literal that you can back up with facts in an argument. So, like, if you're going to talk about forgiveness, maybe you want it to focus on forgiving people who, have been incarcerated or on death row. Like, maybe death row should be abolished. Maybe we should focus more on rehabilitation instead of punishment in the criminal justice system. So those are the kind of things that you'd want to focus on with forgiveness. So peruse some of these thesis statements. I also included, like I always do, the organization for your introduction. It's different with every essay. But for this one, the same as always, you start with a hook, right? And then two and three can be altered. You can do one or the other first. It doesn't really matter. But you want to introduce the text, the author, and you want to summarize. The main text for this essay is The Sun Does Shine. Okay, so not the other Westmore, not Brainology, not any of the articles. The Sun Does Shine has got to be your anchor text. Okay, and then obviously your thesis at the end, an opinion plus reason plus so what, right? So it's complex. Your thesis statement might even be like two or three sentences. Some of my students were like four, which is fine. It's actually more complex. And then right below, I added, this is literally the work cited for the book that we're reading. Notice that the title, it's hard to write in italics, but this is supposed to be italicized. We watched The 13th in my class. You guys can totally use it too. If you have access to the movie, we watched it on Netflix, and this is how you would cite it for that. And then any of the articles we read, they were all online. So pretty much the same format, last name, first name, title, and it's an article, so it should be in quotation marks. Whatever the publication is, The Atlantic, New York Times, whatever, the year it was published, the URL, so you want to copy and paste that URL, and then whenever the date was that you accessed it, you definitely want to have that in there as well. Okay. Some other stuff that I posted. Oh, I also quickly wanted to go over your SA3. So I did move the date of your SA3 to the 10th because I wanted to give you guys a little bit of extra time. Plus, like, I just can't get everything graded by Friday, so I need until Monday, and you'll have your SAA2s back by Monday night. So just to let you know, one thing I wanted to draw your attention to, you are required to have two outside sources for this essay. Now, it can be anything except the textbook. So you've got The Sun Does Shine, right? And then maybe say you use the 13th and one of the articles, or two of the articles, or you use something online that you found somewhere else. Totally fine, as long as there's two outside sources. And just make sure that you, in your body paragraphs, introduce the source, right? Because you don't need to do it in your intro, obviously, because that's where your main text is. But in the paragraph that you're going to discuss it, give a little one sentence summary of the article or the source, and then use the quote, just the same as always. Also, oh, sorry. peer review. So one thing I wanted to clarify, because I was getting a lot of peer reviews that were like a paragraph where people were like, "Hey, good job on your essay." That is not helpful. You have to be really specific. So, make sure you read assignments. You need to answer every one of these questions. So I think there's five. So I would just like number them, and then underneath the person's essay, answer each one of these questions. That's how you're going to get credit for peer review. Okay, and it doesn't have to be a long answer, but just be somewhat specific with people. So at least you're giving them, some help. The other thing I wanted to draw your attention to is the readings that I was talking about for essay three. They're in the readings for week three. So any of these essays can count as an outside source. Okay, so I just wanted to draw your attention to that. Anyway. So yeah, that's basically it. If you guys have any questions, please feel free to reach out to me. I will be mostly unavailable until about Saturday because I'm going camping, but I will be back then. The other thing is we're starting a kind of complicated research essay coming up, and I'm sure you're gonna have a lot of questions about that. So I will be sure to check in with you guys via video on Monday. To clarify anything. And if you guys have questions, let me know, because that kind of lets me figure out like how I should, focus my my lectures. Anyway, I hope you guys have a great 4th of July, and have a safe time, and I'll talk to you guys soon.